Okay, it's Monday morning and many of you are just about to embark on your morning commute to work.
Really? In that case, you're late.
Yes, or some start a bit later than others. When was ours? About 6 hours ago, but that's another story. But how will you get there? Chances are it's by car.
Demographers have released new research into commuting trends in Australia's capital cities. And it seems that we're still a nation that likes to get behind the wheel. In fact, more and more so as the years go on. Mark McCrindle is the social researcher behind this analysis and he joins us now from Sydney. Mark McCrindle, good morning. Thanks for making time for us.
Good morning. Thank you.
And this is from McCrindle Research that we're looking at this social analysis. When we look at it, if we step back for a minute just to give us an overview, how do we compare on world standards when it comes to car usage when getting ourselves to and from work?
We're very attached to our cars. We're up there amongst the top in the world with almost 9 in 10 Australians using a car for some purpose, 7 in 10 using a car to get to work, and that's up from 5 years ago.
And in other countries, say, for example, the United States and some European countries, the use of public transport is much higher. Did you have, as part of your survey, do you have answers to the question as to why people prefer getting behind the wheel of their car?
Yeah, we did. Just 1 in 10 Australians use public transport to get to work, which probably surprises us as to how low that is.
That's a staggeringly low figure, isn't it?
It is, that's right. Sydney actually leads the charge nationally of cities that use public transport.
Yes.
But when we ask the reason why, 54% say that it's because there's no public transport available or not convenient in terms of the time that it's available. And keep in mind that most people who use public transport will use some form of other public transport, some form of other transport to get there as well. 1 in 5 relying on a car to get to that train or that bus as well.
So talk us through some of the main cities. Let's have a look at Sydney and Melbourne to begin with. What are the key differences between those cities when it comes to getting to and from work?
Well, in Sydney, you've got 1.1 million drivers on the road. Melbourne actually has more drivers on the road, even though it's got significantly fewer commuters than Sydney. But Melbourne also leads the charge by way of people riding to work. In fact, almost 40% of all female cyclists who get to work in Australia get to work in the city of Melbourne. So a very female-friendly cycling city there. If we look at some of the other cities, Sydney has actually declined in the number of people taking passengers to work. So the old transit lanes are not as used these days, whereas Tasmania, particularly Hobart, leads the charge there with people by ratio form dropping someone to work. The Northern Territory is the place that people are most likely to walk to work. More than 1 in 10 there walk to work. In most cities, it's number 3 or 4 on the list walking to work. And it's been dropping a little bit over the last 5 years, but Territory strong there. And if we look at Queensland, most likely to use a motorcycle compared to all other cities. And Canberra, also big into push bike riding compared to some of the other capitals, again, in sort of ratio form.
So if Australians are wondering why, and some do from time to time, wonder why not more money is spent on public transport and they don't necessarily want taxpayers' money go towards building new roads or freeways, I guess these figures indicate why that's where the emphasis, because we are putting the emphasis on the roads ourselves by repeatedly and increasingly getting behind the wheel of the car.
That's right. And I think we're not like some of the cities in Asia and even Europe that are more, I guess, conglomerated in terms of their density. The
yes.
sprawl has marked our cities. But it is a surprise that even, for example, those going as a passenger with someone else in a car has also been either hovering or declining over the last few years. So, yeah, we're not as green as we perhaps thought of ourselves as being. And again, we are just rusted onto the use of those cars. We're growing by about 300,000 cars per year in Australia, 13.3 million passenger vehicles on the road in Australia, an all-time record.
Gee, you'd think some Australian car manufacturers could move some units then, couldn't you, looking at those figures? But that's another discussion. Good to talk to you this morning, Mark. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Interesting comments coming in from you about this issue as well. Emrat says driving takes 25 to 30 minutes for him. Bus takes nearly triple that and no flexibility. I try to ride regularly, but not often enough.
Karen, have you ever tried Canberra's public transport? Well, yes, I have, Karen, years ago. Bus would take me 1.5 hours. Car, meanwhile, 20 to 25 minutes. Karen says, therefore, it's a no-brainer. She takes the car in Canberra. The bus system's good, but
yeah, it's disappointing, isn't it? Because everyone, you know, loves to, or most people love to have a car, and the flexibility of it is fantastic. But the great thing about public transport is that someone else parks it for you, someone else maintains
drives,
it for you,
you
someone
read,
drives it.
You can speak to
exactly.
people.
Exactly. So if you can get a public transport system that is on time, reliable and not too slow, really is an absolute lifesaver.
Nicholas, my baby takes the morning train.
Don't sing it. Don't even think about singing it.
But I prefer to drive.
Oh, now I've got that earworm there for the rest of the day. One of the worst ever all-time 80s pop songs.
Thank you very much, Nicholas. Thank you very much, Dolly. You can keep those views coming. You know our email address. You can also get us on Facebook.